I would like to show you guys how I customize Cinema's 4D interface to make my workflow more convenient and, what's more important, significantly faster. Some of you already seen my tutorials and you probably noticed that my interface has more buttons than there are in standard layout. Surely this kind of things are done to each artist individually, but I will actually explain why each feature speeds up my workflow. And if it's something that won't be useful to you, you will at least know how to customize Cinema's 4D interface. So let's open up Cinema 4D. To start customization, go to Window, Customization, Customize Commands, and create a new palette. This will create a blank window in which we will put our buttons. Type in Transfer Objects. That's a really useful feature I use a lot, especially when I need to transfer one object into position of another. Like this. Next feature I use a lot is Center Axis 2. Sometimes object axes are offsetted. It happens particularly often when you're importing models from another 3D software. So this function centers axes so that it matches the geometry. Next option I use a lot is scroll to first active object. When your object manager is overloaded with objects, it might become challenging to navigate. With this function, you can select desired object in viewport, click, and it will appear in the object manager. This is a lifesaver in a project that has like hundreds of elements in it. Next function I use a lot is called Reset PSR. And you might see me using it in my How to Add Objects to Your Footage tutorial. PSR stands for Position Scale Rotation, and this function resets all the values to zero. When I'm creating a new object, usually I do it with Shift Down so that it appears under the main object, and Reset PSR matches the position of newly created object to my previous object. Next function is Loop Selection, and it is helpful when you're modeling. In polygon mode, sometimes you need to select a whole row of polygons or something like that. This selection mode helps to do that. By default, it's located under Select menu, but I prefer to have it in Quick Access. Next function is Fill Selection. Another selection mode, I use it often when working with imported models. It selects polygons in same plane or group and you don't have to individually click every polygon. Alright, next feature I use a lot is not something that comes with Cinema 4D. It's a script that is available for free and you have to install it. The script is called Points to Circle. Link to script itself is in this video description. Download the archive. Then in Cinema 4D, click Edit Preferences, open Preferences folder and drop the file in Library Script. This script is awesome. What it does is when modeling in points mode, you can select points, click on the Points to Circle button and align points in a circle shape. It helps to create neat holes in objects. You're welcome. Now I will create a new palette to add some features that helps me to work with materials. Select materials of active objects. It's same as scroll to active objects in Object Manager, but for materials. It helps to navigate through mess in a complex project. Another feature I use a lot is also not a part of Cinema 4D. I included a link, you can download it. And it's called Disable Enable Materials. This is a little free plugin that does exactly what it says. You can disable all materials to see clean mesh when modeling by one click. If you're modeling a lot, you know how handy it is. It works perfectly with Octane too, by the way. So I put these buttons up here. Enable and Disable Materials. Next feature is called Magic Solo. Another little plugin I use. Link is in description. This plugin hides everything apart from active object. It's very useful when you're modeling and need to see particular element of your model. I put magic solo button right on the left below my main tools palette. Next button I have in my customized interface is called new view panel. It creates a new separate viewport and you can set up views from top, left, right or front in the way you need. Next feature is timeline F-curves. By default it's accessible from window timeline F-curves, but I use this window so much that I prefer to have it in quick access. This is used for animation, in case you didn't know. Next window I always want to see in my interface is console. I use it specifically to see what Octane is doing. If Octane crashes, I see it straight away instead of wasting time thinking it's still loading assets in GPU. See, all the updates are listed like a log in here. I also want to have that live viewer window button at the top here, because sometimes I need to close the window and I want to be able to quickly open it back. Now we will do some viewport adjustments. To do that, click here on Options, Configure, and the Settings window will appear on your right. Let's click View tab first. Settings in this tab are not permanent. If you want, you can set it up every time with every new project. What I like to use here is tinted border. If I set it to 75, then borders outside my resolution will get darker, and it helps me to see if animation is in actual frame, because viewport is scalable and you cannot clearly see what will be in your final frame. So these tinted borders help you with framing. Now let's modify permanent settings. Go to HUD, or however it's pronounced. This tab allows you to enable additional handy notes in your viewport. I usually enable a bunch of stuff, but what I'll just say is that OpenGL statistics will help you to understand how loaded your scene is in terms of geometry. Experiment with the rest. Something might be helpful for your particular workflow, something might not be useful. This is it for interface itself, but there's something else that will speed up your workflow significantly, and it's a hardware thing. This is not a sponsored video, this is something I use all the time, and I can't imagine my life without it anymore. And this thing is called Space Navigator. I will leave a link down below. This thing basically allows you to have those fancy smooth transitions, and I can fly around in 3D space, and it's much more faster than navigating using just icons. I must admit there was a learning curve, but it worth it. One little tip that helped me, I inverted all the axes in 3D connection settings. I hope that now you will be able to create best artworks in the world faster. Thanks for watching.